The default Rigify metarig, with its upgraded face rig, is a pretty good start for most characters. However, depending on your needs, it does have some issues. Luckily, due to its modular design, it is possible to modify the metarig for better results. Let's find out how. Looking at the metarig in edit mode, and the face is just full of bones. By selecting and pressing H, we can hide most of them and just focus on the forehead bones for now. The main issue is that there's just one single bone along the forehead. There is no controls between the eyebrows and the top of the forehead. On the viewport display, select to show the bone names. This will make it easier to see what is going on. What we are going to do is subdivide each bone in order to give us finer control over animating the forehead. This creates an issue in that the naming of bones is somewhat messed up. Ideally, the names should flow down the bone chain from top to bottom for each column along the forehead. While it may not matter so much for just two bones, you could of course subdivide each bone into three or more if you wanted greater control or had a character with a big forehead. Now that we have some extra bones, they need to be moved into position to better follow the curvature of the head. This way, not only do we get greater animation control, but also cleaner deformation as our rig more closely matches the character mesh. Let's test things out. On the metarig, switch back to object mode, and we can now turn the name tags off. Display the existing rig in the viewport, and then, with the metarig still selected, regenerate the rig. At which point, we can hide the metarig and select the character mesh, control-click the rig, and then control-P and reparent with automatic weights. Selecting the rig and going into pose mode, we can test things out. However, it seems there is an issue. Rather than having the whole forehead move with the eyebrow controls, each bone is acting like a single independent deformer. What we really wanted was the whole forehead to squash and stretch with middle controls for finer adjustments. This is easy to fix. It just requires a minor change to the metarig. The big difference is that with the metarig selected, we need to go into pose mode. Select one of the top forehead bones, and then the bones properties panel, and scroll all the way to the bottom in order to find the Rigify type section. It's these Rigify types that help to make the whole rigging system modular based on a metarig. The problem here is that the default skin basic chain doesn't squash and stretch along a series of bones. Instead, clicking on the Rigify type and scroll down the list till you find the skin stretchy chain type. That has a few more options than the basic one, but for now, with just two bones in each forehead chain, they can be all left at the default. Now it's just a matter of doing the same thing to each of the top forehead bones so that each chain will squash and stretch. Once done, we go back to object mode, show the main model, and regenerate the control rig based on our updated metarig. Then, hiding the metarig and switching to pose mode on the control rig, we can test the movement again. This time, both forehead bones squash and stretch together. Yes, the top of the head moves a bit too much, but that just requires a little manual weight painting. Now that we have extra bones in the forehead, we can more easily limit the amount the top of the head moves while still being able to animate the lower forehead and the eyebrows. Turning our attention to the mouth, and chances are we again want more control. The process is much the same as the forehead. We subdivide both the top and bottom lip. Take note that X-axis symmetry is turned on, so that anything we do is applied to both left and right sides. Next is fixing up the naming of all the bones so that it stays consistent with each bone chain. Unlike the forehead, there is no need to change the rigify type of the bone chains, as the default setting should already work just fine. Then it's just a matter of repositioning all the bones so they align around the mouth for better deformation. If moving any bones where multiple chains intersect but aren't connected, make sure to group select and move them all together. Otherwise, you may get errors when generating the rig. Once all done, regenerate the rig and reparent just like before. After confirming it all works, and with some later manual weight painting, we now have a mouth set up with greater control and movement. With some of the easy modifications done, in the next video we will have a look at something a bit more complex, the eyes. So make sure to subscribe and hit like so you don't miss out on the next character creation installment, and I hope to see you then. Cheers.